Good afternoon, all of you all. Yes, so meeting after a long time, after a good break, right? Okay. We are here to go ahead with the new chapter. That's going to be chemical coordination. Preparing for FLT, that's good. Prepare very nicely. And all the best to all of you all. I'm very happy to, see this comment in the comment box that we are preparing for FLT. So I'm very happy about it. Good bit. Keep it up. Meeting tomorrow, yes. Yeah. Well, so let's go ahead with this new chapter, which is going to be called as the chemical coordination or chemical integration. This is the chapter associated with your NCERT Unit 5. The last chapter, okay? So it's not going to be, it's going to be, as I have always told you, that though in the NCERT, the things are mentioned as different chapter, maybe in your 12th standard or 11th standard textbook, it is a different chapter. So this content, which I'm going to start today, is going to be there in your board exams as well. So this is a chapter which is actually belonging to 11th standard NCERT textbook. Yes, chemical coordination and integration. Yes. Okay. So it's actually belonging to your 11th standard NCERT textbook, but it is going to be a part of your neural control and coordination of 12th standard board textbook. So 12th standard boards mein alag se ye chapter ka naam nahi dikhai dega. It's going to be included in your nervous system. Fine, but in NCERT it is given as a different chapter altogether. That's called as your chemical coordination or control and chemical control and integration. ठीक है? So ये जो chapter है बेटा, ये boards के लिए syllabus में है. So again, you might be seeing that I'm more focusing on the board chapters. The reason is for you all to revise it in two ways. One, for your NEET preparation, and second, for your board preparations. So you should have good amount of time to learn the long answer format as well. So for the same reason, these chapters which needs learning and for the boards, I'm considering them to be completed a bit earlier. Okay. Anyways, so let me go directly to the chapter that's going to be chemical control and coordination or chemical control and integration. Okay. Yeah. So very well, you can see over here. We are talking about certain, chemicals that are going to be synthesized in our body. So what are these chemicals and how are they going to be helping in overall working of our entire system? Okay, so of course, yes, yeah, very good, beta. So it's going to be associated with something called as glands. So we know that there are several glands. See, digestive system mein humne dekha tha, that there were so many glands which were associated, correct? In the same way, we have got different number of glands present in our body, which are going to secrete some unique chemicals. And these unique chemicals will be called as hormones. So basically, we are going to talk about hormonal control as well. Yes, bacha Sanika, very correct. It is endocrine system that we are going to talk about. Okay. Now, in this particular picture on your screen, you can very well see a peculiar diagram. Hai na? So, ye jo diagram hai beta. So, in this diagram, you can see this particular thing which is actually like a hanging part. ये आपको hanging वाला दिख रहा है? ऐसे hang हो रहा है ऐसे? हाँ? तो ये जो hanging वाला part है ना बेटा, this is going to be one of the major glands associated with hormone secretions, and this is going to be called as your pituitary gland. What is the name of this gland? Pituitary gland. And if you see this pituitary gland, कहाँ से hang हो रहा है देखो, ये आपको fold दिखाई दे रहा है, this is a broad segment that you can see, and one arm of the broad segment is extended to form this particular gland. So what is this particular area? किसका extension है ये? So this particular area where my cursor is moving right now, है ना? this particular area is going to be called as your hypothalamus. Yes, it's the base of the brain. Exactly, beta. So this is going to be called as your hypothalamus. Hypo means below the thalamus. So where exactly is the thalamus? What is forebrain? What is midbrain? What is hindbrain? Everything I'll be dealing in the chapter of neural control and coordination. Of course, I'll be dealing with it. But as of now, आपको क्या समझना है कि this particular part is the part of our brain which is going to be called as hypothalamus. And one part of the hypothalamus extends, okay, to form this particular gland called as pituitary gland. And can you see this bridge which is connecting the hypothalamus with the pituitary gland? ये देखो ये वाला जो bridge area है, this is going to be called as infundibulum. What we call it as? Infundibulum. Yes. Correct, beta. Okay. So, what is the condition as of now? According to the diagram that we have understood, this is the hypothalamus, which is a part of our brain. Okay. The hypothalamus is forming a tube-like structure over here, which is going to be called as the infundibulum. And at the base, it is forming a lobed structure or a swollen knob-like structure, which is going to be called as the pituitary gland. ठीक है, अब ये जो pituitary gland है, इसमें आपको दिख रहा है बेटा, ये वाला part बड़ा है, ये वाला part छोटा है, और इन दोनों को connect करने वाला भी एक बीच में part है. You can see this very clearly in this diagram. Of course, आगे भी मैंने ये explain किया है, but for the sake of understanding, yes, Sanika, yes, correct, okay. What are those yellow grains? They are going to be the neurons which are responsible for carrying out the impulses. Right? I'll talk about them as well. So see, beta, now what happens? The pituitary gland has been divided into three parts. One part, which is the largest one over here, is going to be called as anterior pituitary. The smaller part, backside pe, is going to be called as posterior pituitary. And ये जो बीच में है, it is called as media, center में है, okay? So anterior pituitary and central part. तो ये जो anterior pituitary है, उसको आगे जाके हम देखेंगे, it's going to be called as adenohypophysis. This is going to be distal. Pars distalis, which is a part of your neurohypophysis, and this is media. Don't worry, I've given everything in detail. But this diagram is actually a very beautiful diagram to understand. So first, just try to understand this diagram. आगे आगे individually मैंने इसको explain किया है. ठीक है? Purple thing are going to be the cells of the hypothalamus, which are going to be called as nuclei. I'll talk about them as well. Okay? So this is all that we have to understand and study. So see, hypothalamus से hang हो रहा है pituitary. अब देखिए इसको है ना, थोड़ा सा समझने की कोशिश कीजिए. Okay, there is one like a boss who is owning a particular company. Okay, what is the function of the boss? The function of the boss is to give commands to whom? Yes, to give orders. Yes, but बिल्कुल करें. To give commands, to give orders, to whom? To his managers, subordinates, जो भी कोई है, जो head है ना, जो head है. No, you can't say slaves. Okay, हाँ, so that the functioning of the company is going to be properly managed. ठीक है, so the boss is going to give command, is going to give instructions. कि for example बता रही हूँ कि उसके पास पांच मैनेजर्स हैं, there are five managers, okay, supervisors, yes, so there are five supervisors or managers. तो ये बंदे ने क्या किया, बॉस ने क्या किया, बॉस has given the orders that I want this thing, ऐसे कुछ 20-25 चीजें बताई कि हमें ये सब चाहिए. Today I want all these things for my work. Now it is very difficult for those five managers or 10 managers to do the things on their own, all the things on their own. So what will they do? कुछ चीजें कुछ खुद करेंगे, है ना, और कुछ चीजें जो है ना उनके subordinates को assign करेंगे. you know, hierarchical system, okay, na? So they give some orders. Suppose they have received, say, 10 orders. So out of the 10 orders, probably 2-3 things they are doing on their own. But rest, you know, like 7-8 things, they are giving it to their subordinates. समझ में आ रही है बात? हाँ, so subordinates को क्या message जा रहा है कि boss ने बोला है ये चाहिए तो come on, do it. In the same way ना बेटा, here also there is a hierarchical system. What is the hierarchical system? Hypothalamus is the boss. Hypothalamus will, even the boss does one or two things, you know this ना? कुछ चीजें बॉस ही कर सकते हैं. He is the boss. So even the boss is going to do one or two things. Rest of the things he has given the orders to his supervisors or managers. In the same way, one or two things will be done by the hypothalamus. The other things, he will send a message to the pituitary gland. क्या है pituitary gland को orders कि ये चीजें मुझे आज चाहिए. Pituitary gland बेचारा अकेला है, वो क्या क्या करेगा? तो वो क्या करता है, कुछ चीजें खुद करेगा एंड सम ऑफ द थिंग्स ही विल असाइन इट टू हिज सबऑर्डिनेट्स. सो हु आर हिज सबऑर्डिनेट्स? हिज सबऑर्डिनेट्स आर गोइंग टू बी द अदर ग्लैंड्स ऑफ अवर बॉडी. सो पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड को हम कहते हैं मास्टर ग्लैंड. यस सिद्धिका, वेरी गुड, यस. सो हु इज गोइंग टू बी द मास्टर ग्लैंड? द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड. व्हाई? बिकॉज ही इज गोइंग टू डिसाइड दैट विच ग्लैंड हैज टू डू व्हाट वर्क. बॉस ने बोला है मुझे एयर टिकट्स चाहिए, बॉस ने बोला है खाना खाने के लिए टुडे आई वांट सो एंड सो थिंग्स, बॉस ने बोला है मेरे लिए अच्छा वाला एक सूट लेके आओ. अब जो मैनेजर है, द सुपरवाइजर है, ही विल ओनली बी एबल टू टेल ना दिस डिपार्टमेंट कैन बी मैनेज्ड वेरी वेल बाय दिस पर्सन, ही इज गुड एट बुकिंग टिकट्स एंड मैनेजिंग विद द फ्लाइट्स. जो बावर्ची है, हा? उसको अगर हम बोलेंगे एयर टिकट्स निकालो तो खत्म ही, मतलब वो बेचारा बॉस इधर ही रह जाएगा. सो एवरी डिपार्टमेंट हैज गॉट इट्स ओन स्पेशलिटी एंड दैट विल बी रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय होम द सुपरवाइजर. इन द सेम वे वी हैव गॉट सो मेनी डिफरेंट ग्लैंड्स इन आवर बॉडी, हु विल बी सुपरवाइज्ड बाय होम? बाय द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड. द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड नोस कि किसके पास से क्या काम करवा के लेना है. Hypothalamus को ये नहीं पता. Hypothalamus doesn't know what who is the ground staff. Hypothalamus is the owner. He only knows to do one or two important things and assign the rest of the things to his managers. So are you understanding? So basically we have to understand what? We have to understand three things. What is the role of hypothalamus? Okay. What is the role of pituitary gland? And what is the role of other glands? All these things are going to be done in detail in this chapter called as chemical coordination and integration. Yes, pituitary is going to be the work distributor. Exactly, but even he will do some work. ऐसा नहीं है कि वो सिर्फ work को distribute करके खुद आराम से सो जाएगा. Even it is going to function, it's going to have certain important functions, right? But now what happens is, along with the glands, जैसे कि जो regular employees होते हैं ना एक company के, along with that now you require other people who are not a part of that company, like courier services. हाँ, तो अगर courier services चाहिए, तो those courier service people are not a part of the company. They are, you know, like their own business है उनका. But they'll come to that company, take the courier, dispatch it, you know, send it to the right person. So in the same way, along with the glands, we have got certain organs, which are also responsible for synthesizing certain chemicals. So this chemicals को बनाने के लिए ये company खोली है. क्या है नाम उस company का? Our body. Okay? Who is the boss? Hypothalamus. Who is the manager or the supervisor? Pituitary. Who are his subordinates? The different glands of our body. Okay? But just like the courier service, just like the postal services, there have to be other helpers who would be helping in executing the entire functioning of our body precisely. So who would do that? That would be done by certain organs. Okay. Yes, Sanika. Very good, beta. Exactly. So this is how our system is going to work precisely under the influence of certain chemicals. So you understood what exactly is this entire chapter that is going to be, you know, dealt with. So we have done with the chapter of digestion, we we have done with the chapter of breathing and exchange, that is respiration. We have done with the chapter of circulation. We have done with the chapter of excretion and osmoregulation. Now, in all these four chapters, okay, we have seen the functioning of each, you know, organ of that particular system. But how all these will be coordinated or how all these will be integrated is something that we have to understand in today's lecture. Okay, got it? So let us understand in detail about all these things. So we are going to talk about the endocrine system. So here you can see there are so many glands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, here also in the place, according to the places also, you can see so many glands. So what does it include? Endocrine system. It includes endocrine glands and their secretions, which are going to be called as hormones. Hormones are non-nutrient chemicals. Very important point. Non-nutrient. They are not responsible for any nutrition. They are not going to provide us with any nutrients. They are non-nutrient chemicals that act as intercellular messengers. So there are messages which are going to be sent via, you know, between the two cells. So this is going to be done with the help of whom? These hormones. Okay? Right? Yeah. So hormones are non-nutrient chemicals that act as intercellular messengers and are produced in trace amounts. Okay? They are produced in trace amounts. Correct? Yes, beta, you're right, Vaishnavi. These are the ones which I had made for them. Okay? These are the ones which I had made for them. Okay? So, yeah. They have, that was, you know, like these things, generally, the bio teachers are always approached for, you know, writing books and all these things. Okay, so yeah, even one of my publications is about to come out. I'll let you all know when will my book get published and all. I'll let you all know, of course. But yes, this was done very long back. Almost, I think so, 5-6 years ho gaye honge. Anyway, so hormones are non-nutrient chemicals. Yes, Sanika. Yes, you're right. So, these are going to be sending what? Intercellular messengers. So, between the two cells, okay, the messages have to be passed and are produced in trace amounts. That is very important. They are not produced in very large amounts. They are produced in very small amounts. That is trace amounts. Okay? Just 1 minute, beta. Give me 1 minute. So, yeah, where were we? So they are not going to be produced in very large amounts. They are going to be produced in trace amounts. Trace is going to be really very, very little amount, okay? Hormones are never going to be produced in too excessive amounts, okay? Fine. So that's about the endocrine system over here. Okay? Then see, look at the glands, as I said. So here you can see the diagram wise, and here you can see, you know, like how they are situated. So first is going to be, of course, the hypothalamus, pituitary gland, pineal gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, thymus gland, adrenal gland, pancreas, and gonads. So all these count beta kitne hai? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Of these 9, hypothalamus is the boss. Pituitary is going to be the मास्टर ग्लैंड एंड ये सब पिट्यूटरी के इन्फ्लुएंस के अंदर आके अपना अपना जॉब करें. ओके, गॉट इट. लुक एट द पोजीशंस, यू कैन सी द पोजीशंस आल्सो वेरी क्लियरली इन दिस पर्टिकुलर डायग्राम. सी, हियर इज गोइंग टू बी द हाइपोथैलेमस, ओके, नियर द ब्रेन रीजन. उधर ही हैंगिंग है अपना पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड, उसके ही एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट रहता है पीनियल ग्लैंड. सो ऑल दीज आर गोइंग टू बी, यू नो, अ पार्ट ऑफ योर हेड रीजन, आई वुड से. Right, thyroid, of course, you can see this butterfly shaped structure near the throat region. That is going to be the thyroid. Okay, parathyroid is going to be, you know, the back side of the thyroid. When I talk about in detail, you will come to know the location and position, everything, no doubt. Then you have got the thymus over here. You can see the thymus, this part. Okay, then you can see adrenal gland, which is going to be a cap-like structure seen on the kidney, है ना? दोनों kidneys के ऊपर मैंने बताया था आपको कि kidney ने cap पहना ऐसे लग रहा है. So that is going to be your adrenal gland, right? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Exactly, movie. That is the way it's going to be, you know, like given. Yes, 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 Shweta. You're right, Bita. You're right. Okay. So this is going to be the adrenal gland. Then you have got the kidneys, of course. Then comes your pancreas. So pancreas ka to diagram we have done very much in detail about what are the cells, what are the secretions, how are they going to be helpful, everything we have done, correct? But still, so this is going to be the pancreas. In case of females, there's going to be presence of ovary and uterus, and in case of males, it's going to be the testes, correct? Right, so this is going to be, you know, your actual positions of all these glands. So what are we going to study today? We are going to study each and everything in detail, right from the hypothalamus up to the testes, right? Gonads तक सारे का सारा हमें एक particular format में study करना है. With two things which are very important. One is what? Hyposecretion and hypersecretion. Hypo means if that particular gland does not produce the right amount of hormone, what would happen? And if it's going to produce too much in excess of the hormone, then what would happen? So basically, from this particular chapter, that is chemical coordination chapter, as far as your boards are concerned or your competitive exams are concerned, they are going to be predominantly asking you about the disorders associated with these, you know, hormonal imbalances. ठीक है? उसके ऊपर हमें focus करना है. Well, then the next comes is hypothalamus. So this is going to be the one who is the boss, as I, you know, I have already told you. Now dekho beta, look at the position, which is very clearly, you know, mentioned over here. See, this is going to be your entire brain, correct? यहाँ से अपना cranium start होता है, है ना? अब यहाँ पर देखो, यहाँ पर I'll talk about the forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain, what are its, you know, parts, everything in the chapter of neural control and coordination. Nervous system का chapter में करना है. But as of now, you can see the position of the hypothalamus. They have circled it over here. Can you see this? This is the position of the hypothalamus. Okay, correct. Now, yeah, almost located at the center. Yes, but. Yes, correct, correct. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, yes. They are divided into four. Very correct. Okay, now what is the function of the hypothalamus? See, neurosecretory cells, which are called as the nuclei of the hypothalamus, secrete the following types of hormone. So in the first slide, which I had shown you, Sankar had asked me, what are those purple cells? Hai na? किसी ने पूछा था येलो सेल्स क्या है और किसी ने पूछा था पर्पल सेल्स क्या है. सो दोस पर्पल सेल्स आर गोइंग टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द हाइपोथैलेमस व्हिच आर गोइंग टू बी कॉल्ड एज द न्यूरो सिक्रीटरी सेल्स आल्सो कॉल्ड एज न्यूक्लियाई. नाउ बेटा प्लीज रिमेम्बर ये जो न्यूक्लियाई है ना इट इज नॉट द न्यूक्लियस नॉर्मली दैट वी आर अज्यूमिंग. ओके द नेम ऑफ द सेल्स इज कॉल्ड एज न्यूक्लियाई. ओके एंड व्हाट आर दे गोइंग टू डू. Those purple cells were going to be, you know, called as nuclei, are going to synthesize four hormones. Rather, I would say four types of hormone. That is more correct. So, first type will be releasing hormone. What do you mean by releasing hormone? Release karna matlab kya karna? Give the authority for going ahead. Yes, come on, go ahead. Inhibiting hormones, you are not allowed to do this, to inhibit, to stop. So one is to synthesize, one is to stop. So who is controlling this? Of course the boss. Ki office ke liye ye ye hum log ko chahiye, uske liye itna itna kharcha aa raha hai. Boss ne dekha ki haan bhai sach mein chahiye, chalo sanction kar diya. Correct? Fir aise agar laga ki already surplus mein hai aur fir bhi agar staff demand kar raha hai, no, inhibit. Not to sanction. So the one who is having the authority to grant the permission is the same who has got the authority to stop the permission. Then only what will happen? Then only there will be a balance maintained. There will not be over expenditure and it won't even happen that jab zarurat hai to nahi kharcha kar rahe aisa bhi nahi ho raha hai. So to maintain the balance, okay? The boss is going to be responsible. In the same way, hypothalamus is going to have the power of what, beta? Controlling. Whenever required, it will allow the synthesis of certain hormones. And when not required, it will withhold, it will inhibit, it will stop its production. Yes, Vaishnavi. Correct, beta. Yes, beta. Very right. Okay. So this is how. हाँ रिलीज एंड इनहिबिट्स इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द हाइपोथैलेमस. वो बॉस है ना वो बराबर उसको पता है कि हाउ टू मैनेज विद हिज ओन कंपनी. सो ईच वन्स हाइपोथैलेमस हमारे वी नेवर थिंक लाइक दैट वे राइट राइट व्हाट वी थिंक आई नो व्हाट इज राइट आई नो व्हाट इज परफेक्ट आई ओनली हैव गॉट द नॉलेज. मेन है वो अंदर बैठा है जिसका नाम हाइपोथैलेमस है. ओके yes, then it will be like a mixture, right? Okay, then problem. So what is going to happen with the hypothalamus? Hypothalamus is going to be the control point, either to allow the synthesis or to stop the synthesis. So two types of hormones are types bol rahi hu main. Okay, so under that types, there could be, you know, 10 different releasing hormones. There would be 10 different inhibiting hormones. Okay. So releasing and inhibiting का मतलब समझना है बस. And the third type, as I said, sometimes some things are done by the boss himself, right? So this time the hypothalamus is saying he is giving the orders to the pituitary, but some things he is going to do on his own. What is that thing? See, he himself, the hypothalamus itself, is responsible for synthesizing two important hormones, oxytocin and vasopressin. So who is going to form, who is going to synthesize, who is going to make directly, directly kaun oxytocin or vasopressin directly kaun bana raha hai? Na manager bana raha hai, na subordinates bana raha hai, the boss is making it. So it is the hypothalamus who is responsible for making oxytocin and vasopressin. Did you all understand? This is a common question that is asked in your NEET examination. That oxytocin and vasopressin is synthesized by, because these are the only two direct hormones which are going to be synthesized by hypothalamus. Rest all are messengers. Baki jitne bhi hormones hai na, wo messages bhejte rahenge. Okay, orders dete rahenge. No, beta. Posterior pituitary will not secrete these two. Posterior pituitary is only store these two. स्टोरेज के लिए पोस्टीरियर है, सिंथेसिस के लिए नहीं. हु इज गोइंग टू सिंथेसाइज, दैट इज व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू कम टू व्हेन आई गो टू न्यूरोहाइपोफाइसिस. ओके, सो द वन हु इज गोइंग टू सिंथेसाइज इज द डायरेक्ट बॉस, ऑक्सीटोसिन एंड वैसोप्रेसिन डायरेक्टली बाय हाइपोथैलेमस. ओके, I'll tell you. Oxytocin का भी मैं बता रही हूँ, मैं हर एक का बता रही हूँ, don't worry. I'm going to talk about each and everything. Okay? Now, what is going to happen? See, basically, releasing hormone, inhibiting hormone are messages sent to whom? Pituitary gland. इसको release करो, इसको inhibit करो. हाँ, तो ये signals pituitary को मिल रहे हैं. लेकिन मैं खुद क्या करूँगा? मैं खुद ऑक्सीटोसिन बनाऊंगा, मैं खुद वैसोप्रेसिन बनाऊंगा, और जो मैंने बनाया है उसको स्टोरेज के लिए मैं पिट्यूटरी को दे रहा हूँ. आई टॉक अबाउट इट. फाइन, सो प्लीज रिमेम्बर दीज टू पॉइंट्स वेरी प्रिसाइजली. दैट इज न्यूरोसेक्रेटरी सेल्स आर कॉल्ड एज न्यूक्लियाई, विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सिंथेसाइजिंग, रिलीजिंग हार्मोन, इनहिबिटिंग हार्मोन, विच आर मैसेजेस. एंड ऑक्सीटोसिन एंड वैसोप्रेसिन आर डायरेक्ट हार्मोन्स विच आर गोइंग टू बी यूज्ड. इज इट फाइन? In short, oxytocin is used for development of the mammary glands and formation of the milk during pregnancy. That is oxytocin. Yes. Vasopressin, ADH. Yes. Only during delivery of the female, nahi beta. That is going to be something else. I'll talk about. Batati. ठीक है. तो यहाँ तक का मतलब point समझ में आया? Having any difficulty with hypothalamus? These are the only points that you have to remember for hypothalamus. Anyone having any difficulty, beta? Is it very simple? Is it very clear? Oxytocin aage aayega. Don't worry. As of now, just remember oxytocin and vasopressin are only two hormones which are directly synthesized by hypothalamus, which are not messengers. They are not messages that are going to be sent to other glands. Wo khud bana rahe. No. That's what I told you all just now, that these nuclei are not the nuclei of our cells. Ye cells ka naam hi nuclei hai. So the name of the neurosecretory cell is itself going to be called as nuclei. So don't get confused. Nuclei are the cells of hypothalamus. Please remember this. Okay? Any other difficulty, any other doubts, please let me know. All good? Hare Anshwe, let me go with the flow. I'll talk about tomorrow. Don't worry. Okay, na? Is it fine? Sure. Can I go ahead with the next point? Huh? Sure. Let's go with the next one. What is the next one? See, so releasing hormones. What do you mean by the word releasing hormones? So see, only three functions. Yes. Yes, Bhumi. Yes, beta. Okay, see. Hypothalamus has got three functions. What are the three functions? The first, about the releasing hormone. So see, what are they saying? It stimulates secretion of pituitary hormones. मतलब manager को क्या करेंगे? Supervisor को command करेंगे, orders देंगे. तो उस pituitary को activate करने के लिए, उस pituitary को stimulate करने के लिए messages भेजने पड़ेंगे. What could be the message? Like how you do WhatsApp, or you make a call, or you put a text message करते हो. What are you doing? You're reaching out to that other person in some of the other ways. Here, what is the way? Which is the only way? The only way is the chemical way. So hypothalamus will secrete a chemical which will reach the pituitary. Pituitary will get stimulated. Means it will get the signal, it will get the order, it will receive the order, and it will start secreting its own hormones. Means what will happen? For example, okay, the boss has said that I want to book two tickets to London for, say, 1st of January. Okay, now this message was sent by the boss, say via the phone, to the supervisor. What the supervisor has done? He has said, okay, boss, I got your message. He will call up, or he will text, or he will WhatsApp to the concerned person that 1st January ka London ka do tickets chahiye. Okay, so the message has been now passed from the supervisor to his subordinate via WhatsApp. The message from the boss was sent to the manager via phone call. You understood this? In the same way, the hypothalamus is going to send its releasing hormone ka message to pituitary gland. Pituitary gland will execute the message and it will give the message to that particular organ, or sometimes he will do on his own also. Okay. So he may give that orders to the organ by sending another chemicals. So suppose this particular chemical is synthesized by the pituitary, will reach one of the glands. Okay. The glands will come to know that now they have to synthesize their hormones, means they have to actually work on what the message has come to them. Yes, it's a chain reaction. Very correct. It's like, you know, have you all played passing the parcel? Khela hai na bachpan mein ki abhi bhi khelte ho. In the same way, one message to another, to another, to another, like that bit is going to get executed very precisely. So stimulates the secretion of the pituitary hormones, who the releasing hormones of the hypothalamus. So hypothalamus has released the chemicals which have reached the pituitary. The pituitary gland understood what is to be done. So now they will release their hormones. For example, gonadotropin releasing hormone, GnRH, which we have already studied in the chapter of human reproduction. Do you remember this? ये याद है GnRH याद है नाम gonadotropin releasing hormones. हा exactly. So GnRH कौन release कर रहा है? देखो, who is releasing GnRH? Pituitary gland, correct. Who gave the orders to him make GnRH? Hypothalamus. Very good, Vaishnavi. Yes beta, very correct, very correct. So now you all are understanding. You're understanding? Yeah, Palak. Correct, beta. Correct. Look at the second point, inhibiting hormone. So, the pituitary gland has got the power of controlling the excessive production or inhibition of certain activities. So, see, inhibiting hormones are going to inhibit secretions of the pituitary hormones. Example, somatostatin inhibits release of growth hormone from the pituitary. So already a person is, you know, well grown up now. Or agar excess grow hoga to he will look like a giant, right? So what the pituitary knows now, enough of his growth. Now stop it. Pituitary cannot take the decision of stopping on its own unless and until it is an order from the hypothalamus. So hypothalamus will recognize ki enough of the growth hormone. It will tell pituitary, stop it. तो स्टॉप इट करने के लिए भी उसको फोन करना पड़ेगा कि नहीं? हाँ या ना? सो अगेन इट हैज टू सेंड अ मैसेज वाया व्हाट? द केमिकल्स. सो ही विल सेंड, हाइपोथैलेमस विल सेंड टू टाइप्स ऑफ मैसेजेस. वन केमिकल मैसेज विल कम एंड से स्टार्ट रिलीजिंग. द अदर टाइप ऑफ केमिकल विल कम एंड से इनफ ऑफ इट, नाउ स्टॉप इट. सो पिट्यूटरी हैज गॉट नो कंट्रोल अबाउट इनिशिएटिंग और स्टॉपिंग. हु इज द अल्टीमेट बॉस? हाइपोथैलेमस. Got it now? So this is your releasing hormone. This is your inhibiting hormone. Now look at the third point, which hypothalamus was secreting, oxytocin and vasopressin. Mainly controls feedback. Yes. Release GnRH also and stop GnRH also. Release growth hormone also, stop growth hormone also. For every release, there is an inhibiting. And for every inhibiting, there is a stimulating. It's a complete control. Okay. See, oxytocin and vasopressin, these are transported axonally, means via the axons, and stored in pituitary. So they are only going to be stored in pituitary, not formed in pituitary, formed in the hypothalamus itself. Okay. Look at this diagram, which is a part of your NCERT textbook, of course. So see, this is going to be a part of your hypothalamus. These are your neurons. Okay, this is going to be your posterior pituitary. This is going to be the anterior pituitary. Here there will be your media, beech mein. Theek hai na? So, ye via the axons. Via the axons. You can see this axons are actually, this one is to actually coming into the posterior pituitary. So, it is the one who will cause the vasopressin and oxytocin to descend down into the posterior pituitary. जो आगे मैं बताऊंगी. So any difficulty till your hypothalamus is going to go ahead with releasing hormone, inhibiting hormone, oxytocin and vasopressin. These two releasing and inhibiting will be always given an order to the pituitary, no one else. While oxytocin and vasopressin will be completely stored inside the posterior pituitary. बोलो बेटा कुछ difficulty है इसमें. Anyone who is having any problem with understanding of any of these points, kindly tell me. No doubts. Very good, Niharika. बाकी के लोग बोलो बेटा कुछ डिफिकल्टी है तो. So I hope you all are understanding these. You know, things they are very important. Next is the pituitary gland. So now we have understood the role of the boss. Now let us understand the role of the master gland, supervisor, manager, whatever you want to say. ठीक है? चलो ये देखो बेटा. Pituitary gland, it is located in a bony cavity called as cella turcica. Please remember this name of the bone. ओके okay? ये कैविटी है और ये कैविटी को कैविटी मतलब क्या व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कैविटी अ गैप यू नो एन ओपन स्पेस सो इट इज गोइंग टू बी लोकेटेड पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इज गोइंग टू बी लोकेटेड इनसाइड द कैविटी ऑफ अ बोन द नेम ऑफ द बोन विल बी योर स्फेनॉइड बोन ओके आई थिंक यू रिमेंबर द स्फेनॉइड बोन आई हैड शोन यू ड्यूरिंग ब्रीदिंग एंड एक्सचेंज यू रिमेंबर इन दैट चार्ट आई हैड शोन यू स्फेनॉइड बोन Anyways, if not, then in locomotion chapter, again, we're going to have, you know, the detailed study about the bones. So that time I'll show you. Anyways, so this bone is going to have a cavity, a cup-like structure. And in this cavity, there is going to be the placement of this gland, which is going to be called as the pituitary gland. Okay, so that cavity is going to be called as cella turcica. Don't forget this name, cella turcica. It's a very common question which has been asked for so many years. It is attached. It means who? The pituitary gland. It is attached to the hypothalamus by a stalk, which is going to be called as infundibulum, which I had already explained in the beginning. Look at the position. See. So here it's going to be your pituitary gland. यहाँ पर है. But इसको हमने अगर enlarge किया ना तो you can see here. और इसको और enlarge किया तो ये देखो यहाँ पर बहुत clearly दिखाई देगा बेटा. This is going to be a very important diagram. Hypothalamus, optic chiasma associated with vision. And the other end, you can see this circle that they have made now, they're talking about this region. Okay. So here you can see very clearly, this is a bone. Ye dikh raha hai aapko? This is a bone. This is the cavity, which is called as cella turcica. So here they are saying it, that hypophyseal fossa in cella turcica of the sphenoid bone. So this bone is going to be called as the sphenoid bone. This is the cavity which is going to be called as cella turcica. Here this particular entire pituitary gland has been located. Now this is going to be your posterior pituitary. Can you see this? Posterior pituitary. This posterior pituitary is further divided into two parts. Infundibular stalk, which is this. Stalk means what? Extension, है ना? A connector, a tube-like structure, which is connecting the hypothalamus with pars nervosa. So ये देखो बेटा, ये infundibulum है, ये पूरा, पूरा का पूरा ये infundibulum है. यहाँ से ये stalk नीचे आके यहाँ पर बना आपका pars nervosa. On the other hand, look over here. This is anterior pituitary, which is going to be called as adenohypophysis. Which is further divided again into three parts. See, pars tubularis. Can you see this pinkish color structure? ये देखो. Along with this, can you see this? Not the brown one, the pink one. So it's like, you know, holding it together. So for example, yeah. So for example, this is going to be the you know extension of the hypothalamus, I'm holding this like this way. Okay, so my this finger as well as this finger is a part of my hand only. Agreed? So even this is going to be a part of pars tibularis, even this is going to be a part of pars tibularis. Did you understand? So that entire collar like thing that you can see, which is holding this particular position, right, is going to be your pars tibularis. Okay, then you can see your pars intermedia. Ye dikhai de raha hai सेंटर में, जिसने पार्स पोस्टीरियर पिट्यूटरी और एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी को डिवाइड किया है. दिस इज पार्स मीडिया इंटरमीडिया. ओके, एंड हियर यू कैन सी द लार्ज पार्ट इज वुड बी पार्स डिस्टल्स. ठीक है, सो अगेन पे अटेंशन, द एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द हाइपोथैलेमस इन अ ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर is going to be called as your infundibulum. Okay, it is the stalk of hypothalamus. It will give rise to the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland will be divided into three parts: anterior pituitary, posterior pituitary, and central pituitary. Anterior pituitary will be further divided into three parts: pars tibularis, which is actually forming a collar-like structure, correct? Pars intermedia, which is the one who is separating the posterior and the anterior pituitary, and pars distalis, which is going to form the major swollen knob of anterior pituitary. Similarly, the posterior pituitary will be divided into two parts: the infundibular stalk and pars nervosa. So, pars distalis, पार्स नर्वोसा, ये दो मेन स्वोलन नॉब्स हैं. दिखाई दे रहे हैं आपको, देखो पार्स नर्वोसा भी स्वोलन है, पार्स डिस्टालिस भी स्वोलन है, बट डिस्टालिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी व्हाइल नर्वोसा इज अ पार्ट ऑफ पोस्टीरियर पिट्यूटरी. एनी डिफिकल्टी इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग दीज थिंग्स? दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एनीवन हैविंग एनी डिफिकल्टी विद अंडरस्टैंडिंग दीज थिंग्स? बेटा बताओ बताओ बताओ, किसी को कोई कंफ्यूजन हो तो बोलो. Tell me. Got it? Very clear? All of you, please let me know. But if you are not following, na, मुझे बताओ. Don't feel shy. कोई भी point में कोई भी doubt है तो please ask me. Of course, to ask me, you can type it, or obviously. Now regularly we'll be meeting each other, so that time also you can ask me, no doubt. Okay, yeah, I'll tell the function of each of them. Okay, whole red circle is going to be a part of your infundibulum along with the pars tibularis. That is that entire red color ka circle jo banaya. Theek hai, stalk. I'll let you all know, beta. So I've already, I'm in that particular thing only, that how to go ahead with those things. So yeah, tomorrow I'm coming to Velepalli branch. I had already visited Borivali branch, and my dear Borivali students, don't worry, I'm going to come in the coming week as well. Okay, so आने वाले वीक में भी मैं आऊंगी, आपके एफएलटी के डाउट्स लूंगी, डोंट वरी एट ऑल. एंड एज वी हैड डिसाइडेड अबाउट द रिवीजन चैप्टर्स, वी विल बी गोइंग अहेड विद दैट एज वेल. सो डोंट वरी बोरिवली के बच्चे, विलेपार्ले अंधेरी, टुमारो आई एम गोइंग टू कम ओवर देयर एज वेल ना. सो डोंट वरी. ओके, ऑल यू नो द चैप्टर्स वुड बी रिवाइज्ड एंड यू विल कम टू नो अबाउट योर डिफिकल्टीज एंड सम एक्स्ट्रा पॉइंट्स एंड सम clarifications, whatever are there, feel free when we meet each other. Anyways, but I'll tell you about tomorrow's chapter. Don't worry. We had stopped at reproductive health wala chapter, if I'm not wrong, which I have taken the revision and doubt session in Borivali branch. I think we'll go like that way only. So even for other branches, I'll go ahead with the doubt session of reproductive health chapter tomorrow. Along with that, other doubts also, if you have got, you can clear it. But because I have started, I think, I mean, the online sessions that we had on Tuesdays, right? 1 hour wala sessions, that time we had to go ahead with reproductive health, which we had stopped at. We couldn't do that. So I have started with that in the Borivali branch. So I'll go ahead with the same trend for other branches as well. ठीक है? Anyways, so as of now, any difficulty with understanding of the anterior pituitary, posterior pituitary, and media? Anterior, 3 parts, pars tibialis, pars intermedia, pars distalis. Posterior, 2 parts, infundibular stalk and pars nervosa. Okay? We'll do all chapters. Wait, I'm just focusing for you to, you know, get through with your long answer learning, beta. Aapka problem kya hota hai na? Boards ka problem ho jata hai because 12 boards ke jo chapters hai, wo agar bahut delay ho gaye na, then it becomes difficult for you all to mug up the things for the long answers. So that Animal Kingdom chapter is not going to be there for your 12 boards, though it is going to be there for the NEET. So I'm going to take all. Don't worry. Okay, so we go with the next one. That is going to be what? The pituitary gland ka jo maine abhi bataya, the same thing. See, parts of pituitary, anterior pituitary called as adenohypophysis, posterior pituitary called as neurohypophysis. Adenohypophysis is further divided into pars distalis, pars intermedia, and neurohypophysis is basically your nervosa only. ठीक है? Look at this particular diagram. It will become all the more clear to you all. Okay? Look at this. Now here you can see anterior pituitary or adenohypophysis consists of pars tibialis. Now you can see how it has held this infundibulum. पकड़ के रखा है stalk को. Yeah? Then see, this is your pars intermedia, which is separating the posterior and the anterior pituitary. This is your pars distalis, which is really large. Hai na? This is going to be your pars nervosa, basically, which is neurohypophysis. Is it fine? Okay. Same thing, but in a very systematic order, I have tried to put it. Now look at this. First, we're going to talk about pars distalis. Pars tibialis is not included. It is not like that. It is not included. It is collectively going to be in a tube-like structure. So tibialis is going to be the tube-like structure. ठीक है? ये देखो, यहाँ पर डाला है देखो, pars tibialis. हाँ? So यहाँ पर देखो बेटा, pars tibialis, distalis, intermedia, nervosa. This is going to be the infundibulum. Now see, pars distalis पे हमें focus करना है, okay? What is the function of pars distalis? So, hypothalamus has sent the signal to the pituitary gland. What is the signal? One of the managers ke paas signal aaya. Wo manager ka naam kya hai? Pituitary gland ke manager ka naam kya hai? Pars distalis. Theek hai? It is a part of your anterior pituitary. So, uske paas signal aaya. Ki come on, start releasing certain hormones. जैसे उसके पास मैसेज आया रिलीज करने का, इमीडिएटली पार्स डिस्टालिस हैज ओबेड द ऑर्डर्स ऑफ द हाइपोथैलेमस एंड स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स सी सोमैटोट्रोपिन और ग्रोथ हार्मोन. व्हाट ही हैज स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग? सोमैटोस्टैटिन या फिर ग्रोथ हार्मोन, जीएच कहते हैं हम लोग. प्रोलैक्टिन, व्हिच इज एब्रिविएटेड एज पीआरएल, थायराइड स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन TSH. Now please understand this. ये जो manager है, जैसे hypothalamus ने खुद ने दो चीजें बनाई थी, vasopressin and oxytocin, वैसे ही pars distalis directly दो चीजें बनाता है, GH and PRL. While releasing and inhibiting hormone कैसे hypothalamus ने pituitary को भेजा था signal, वैसे pituitary will now send the signals to concerned glands. That is, thyroid gland ke paas signal aayega, start making your hormones. That is T3, T4, ye sab. Okay? To ye kaise bhejega wo? Via thyroid stimulating hormone. So the pars distalis will make the third chemical, which will move via the bloodstream to reach the thyroid gland. The thyroid gland will get stimulated to make its own hormones now. Did you all understand? So hypothalamus send the message to pituitary. Pituitary ka anterior pituitary ka pars distalis ne wo suna. Usne TSH banaya. Jo jaake thyroid ke paas aaya aur bola, come on, start making your hormones. So which are the hormones that the thyroid gland will make is a different story. So thyroid gland kaun se hormones banayega, uska function kya hai, that is a different story. But to give the instructions to the thyroid gland, start making your hormones, comes from the pituitary gland via TSH. Did you all understand this? So thyroid ko stimulate karne wala hormone kaun banata hai beta? The pituitary gland. Who tells the pituitary gland that make TSH? Hypothalamus. Is it okay? In the same way, look at the fourth one, adrenocorticotropic hormone, ACTH. It is going to be in the adrenal gland. So adrenal gland ko bhi activate karna padta hai. Come on, start making your own hormones. So usko bhi good morning karane ka kaam kaun karega? The hormones from pituitary gland. Follicle stimulating hormones, we have already studied about reproduction chapter. You already know the role of FSH, correct? The role of FSH in males as well as in females. I hope you all remember these things. Do you? At least now FLT RI, so I hope you all have at least, you know, tried to go back and try to recollect these things. Have you all tried recollecting? Or no, not yet? Study, huh? If you have not yet started. Okay, so I'm sure that you all have started. You all are my, you know, really, matlab, achche bachche ho tum. So I know, like, you know, you will always follow the things and do the things correctly. Okay? Yes, beta. Yes, Bhumi. Yes, beta. Bilkul correct. So thyroid stimulating hormone will stimulate the thyroid. Come on, start your work. Do your own work. So thyroid gland will start its work. In the same way, adrenal gland will also get an intimation. Chalo beta, aapka kaam chalu kar do. So adrenal gland bhi unka kaam chalu kar dega. Similarly, FSH apna kaam chalu kar dega. And LH apna kaam chalu kar dega. Okay? So your thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropin hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, prolactin, somatotropin, all are a product of whom, beta? Pars distalis. So if you look into the details, there are six peculiar chemicals that are going to be synthesized by pars distalis. Would you be able to remember all six of them? Growth hormone, that is GH, PRN, TSH, ACTH, FSH, LH. अब क्या होता है, बाकी के सारे याद रहते हैं. ये जो ACTH है ना, उसका फुल फॉर्म मैं पूछूंगी ना दो महीने के बाद, गए काम से. Don't do like that way. You should know the full form of them as well. What is it? Adrenocorticotropic hormone. थोड़ा लंबा है बट इजी है. ओके, गॉट इट? एनी डिफिकल्टी? इफ द क्वेश्चन कम्स इन योर एग्जामिनेशन that pars distalis is associated with the production of, remember, all these. Last four hormones, all hormones are secreted by pituitary only, but they all are going to be for the stimulation of the organs. Okay, they all are going to be for the stimulation of the hormones. Nahi to organ ko kaise samjhega? Organ bol rahi hu, gland. Nahi to gland ko kaise samjhega, usko kya banane ka hai? तो ग्लैंड का गुड मॉर्निंग कराने के लिए हार्मोन्स की जरूरत है. एंड दीज हार्मोन्स विल बी सिंथेसाइज्ड बाय हूम? पार्स डिस्टालिस ऑफ द पिट्यूटरी. नहीं तो दे विल नॉट सी. द बॉस हैज गिवन द इंफॉर्मेशन बाय अ कॉल टू हूम? टू दिस मैनेजर. अगर मैनेजर भूल गया क्या वो मैसेज कंसर्न डिपार्टमेंट को देने के लिए, तो वो डिपार्टमेंट वाले को पता चलेगा क्या व्हाट दे हैव टू डू? So the message has to reach the concerned department now. So for that, that particular manager needs to call up that department people. In the same way, these hormones are like phone call. Who will reach the concerned departments, means who would reach the concerned glands. Only then the glands will be in the position to synthesize next group of hormones. Did you understand beta? Can you understand how it is? हाँ देखो अलार्म बजता है तुम्हारे घर पे. हाँ मॉर्निंग में अलार्म बजता है, मम्मा उठती है, करेक्ट? फिर मम्मा आपको उठाती है, हाँ या ना? अगर अलार्म ही नहीं बजा तो मम्मी भी सोती रहेगी, आप भी सोते रहोगे, एंड देन यू आर लेट. सो इन द सेम वे सबसे पहले हाइपोथैलेमस जो है वो उठेगा, वो उठाएगा पिट्यूटरी को, फिर पिट्यूटरी उठेगा वो उठाएगा ये ग्लैंड्स को. गेट मी? यस या यस यस बेटा यस अर्पिता यू आर राइट करेक्ट ओके गॉट दिस नाउ. वो मम्मी लोग के पास इनबिल्ट अलार्म होता ही है, दैट इवन आई नो. एंड एस्पेशली व्हेन यू ऑल हैव गॉट लेक्चर्स, हाँ जब बच्चों के लेक्चर्स हैं, एग्जाम है, और तुम्हारे पास इनबिल्ट अलार्म कब होता है पता है? आई नो आपके पास इनबिल्ट अलार्म कब होता है, जब भी पिकनिक जाना होता है. आई नो कभी नहीं उठोगे जल्दी, पिकनिक का नाम लेते ही टुमारो मॉर्निंग आई एम गोइंग टू गो आउट फॉर अ पिकनिक, रात भर तुम्हारा अलार्म तुम्हें सोने नहीं देगा, है ना? अरे बाप रे ये कोविड टाइम है बेटा. एनीवे सो ऑल सिक्स वुड यू बी एबल टू रिमेंबर व्हाट दी पार्स डिस्टालिस इज गोइंग टू मेक, एनी डिफिकल्टी इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग दीज? क्लियर गुड. वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज गोइंग टू बी सोमैटोट्रॉपिक हार्मोन. पहले वो देखते हैं. हाँ तो हर एक का मैं बताने वाली हूँ, हर एक का. सी पार्स डिस्टालिस ऑफ द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इज गोइंग टू सिंथेसाइज सोमैटोट्रोपिन और ग्रोथ हार्मोन. Now, as I said, it is not going to stimulate any organ or any gland. It is itself going to make the things whatever, you know, khud kaam karega ye. Kisi ko order nahi dega. So, what is the function of this particular somatotropic hormone? See, it is going to be synthesized for body growth. So, you grow in your height, your breadth and overall, you know, the structure of a small baby is going to eventually increase day by day. Correct? Of course, there is a spike during puberty of this particular hormone. I do agree. But every day, every minute, you all are growing, right? Correct? So this is going to be the hormone which is going to be responsible for body growth. Over secretion of GH causes gigantism. Giants bante hai log. Which is abnormal growth. Here in this picture, you can see this particular person, Sultan Kosar. ये देखो, ये जो बंदा है, जिसका नाम है Sultan Kosar, ये जो है, इसको देखो बेटा, he is 8 feet 1 inch tall. कितना, my God, see, he is so tall, correct? And you can see he is holding a stick in his hand. He is not able to walk. Yes, it is very difficult for them. 8 feet is like abnormally tall. Okay? अरे खड़ा रहेगा तो भी ठीक है, सोएगा कहाँ? अपने जो normal bed की size होती है maximum, you know, it's around 6 feet. It becomes difficult nowadays for you people also to, you know, like if you all are really tall, right? If you all are tall na, it becomes difficult for you all to fit also into this normal beds. Okay? He has got his long bones too long. Yeah, you have to go for customized bed. Yes. Even your bed is getting smaller. Nah, I know. So the same problem is with my son as well. Okay. So even he is, you know, like usko fit hona bed mein aajkal bahut, matlab height ke hisab se bahut hi zyada problem ho. No. Acromegaly alag hai beta. Acromegaly aage bataungi what is it. This is going to be called as gigantism or gigantism, whatever you want to pronounce. Both are correct. So it becomes very difficult for him to balance such a huge structure. You know, itna wo huge hai ki usko uske यू नो लेग्स पे उसको बैलेंसिंग डिफिकल्टी इज होल्डिंग अ स्टिक इन हिज हैंड सी राइट सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज हाइपर सिक्रीशन और ओवर सिक्रीशन ऑफ GH ग्रोथ हार्मोन ओके अदर लुक एट द अदर पर्सन ही इज कॉल्ड एज हे पिंग पिंग हिज नेम इज हे पिंग पिंग आई एम नॉट मैं कुछ नहीं बोल रही हूँ यहाँ पर ओके He is going to be the one who is so short, whose height is only 2 feet. 2 feet, 5.37 inches. Okay. Yes, yes, exactly. Exactly, yes, Anjumita, toh wahi problem hoti hai. So look at him. He's so short. That is hyposecretion of GH. I think you all might have visited, you might have, you know, enjoyed the circus. Kabhi gaye ho circus mein? Dekhne ke liye. देखा है सर्कस देखा है आप लोग ने कि नहीं देखा है ना तो वहां पर वो छोटे होते हैं देखो ड्वार्फ्स होते हैं वो जनरली यू नो प्ले द रोल ऑफ क्लाउन्स वो क्लाउन्स बनते हैं अपने को हंसाने की कोशिश करते हैं दे आर एक्चुअली ड्वार्फ्स दे आर वेरी शॉर्ट सो व्हाट इज रॉन्ग इन देम दैट इज गोइंग टू बी कॉल्ड एज ड्वार्फिज्म सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ड्वार्फिज्म The GH is not going to be produced in the right amount. Yes, exactly, 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 beta. Yes, Vaishnavi. I don't know. I have never seen. Maybe. Yeah. So different cells signal the hypothalamus glands to inhibit the pituitary secretion. Yes. Sometimes what happens, na, there is some sort of deformity from the birth time itself. So jisko hum congenital defect kehte hain. So right from the birth, probably there was some, you know, development of the hypothalamus was not correct or the development of pituitary gland is not, you know, up to the mark. Then these things are going to happen. Okay. So these are sometimes inborn defects, as we say. So these are inborn defects. Which are the inborn defects? Gigantism and dwarfism are inborn defects or we call it as congenital defects. Okay. Yeah, yeah, that's what it's because of. Yeah, it is because of genetics as well. Correct. Very right. Very right. So what happens is due to whatever reasons, okay, it could be any XYZ reason, but it's going to be an inborn defect. So from the birth itself, these particular characteristics would be seen in that baby. Okay. But what is acromegaly? That is something we'll be talking about on the next slide, which I've put up. Okay, any difficulty with understanding gigantism and dwarfism, beta? Kisi ko doubt hai? Anyone having any difficulty with gigantism? No, na? Okay. Now let's see the next one. What is acromegaly? Ye dekho. Same, ha? Pituitary gland ka pars distalis, anterior part of the pituitary. सोमैटोट्रोपिन हार्मोन की बातें हो रही है जीएच की बातें हो रही है लेट अस सी ओवर सिक्रीशन ऑफ जीएच इन एडल्ट्स लुक एट दिस वर्ड इन एडल्ट्स मेनली इन द मिडिल एज वुड बी अराउंड 35 टू 45 के बीच में ओके कॉजेस एक्रोमेगाली व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी नथिंग बट सीवियर डिसफिगरमेंट एस्पेशली ऑफ द फेस लुक एट दीज फेसेस कैन यू सी कैसा लंबा चौड़ा फेस हो गया ये बंदे का इट्स सो लॉन्ग राइट लुक एट हिज फेस इट्स कंप्लीटली डिसफिगर्ड एंड दिस इज नॉट फ्रॉम द बर्थ दिस पर्टिकुलर इम्पेयरमेंट इज नॉट फ्रॉम द बर्थ ऑल ऑफ अ सडन ड्यूरिंग द मिडिल एज व्हेन दैट पर्सन एक्सपायर्स इट मेल और फीमेल इट कुड बी इन बोथ ओके या एग्जैक्टली जॉ बोन इलोंगेट हो जाता है चिन रीजन ब्रॉड हो जाता है ना So it could be a male, it could be a female, it could be, you know, in any of the sexes, not predominantly for a particular sex. What has happened? See, the face is completely disfigured and it has happened after a particular age. It was not there initially. Okay. So this is going to be called as over secretion of GH in the adult. So please, my dears, look at the question very precisely. If the question is going to be asked based on gigantism, From birth, dwarfism, from birth, acromegaly after adulthood. Okay, it leads to serious complications, and sometimes it may even lead to premature death, because all the bones of the body are going to, you know, expand exponentially, and it becomes very difficult for maintaining their orientation, basically. So early diagnosis of the disease is difficult. It may be undetected for many years, and that is the reason, you know, it just happens all of a sudden, and then you realize that, oh my God, am I a victim of acromegaly? Okay, it could happen in anyone, but many a times it's going to be, you know, a genetic disorder or a mutation that has occurred during the embryo formation. Okay, yeah, that is what I said, that during the embryo formation, if there was some problem with respect to these, formation of these glands and all, it might happen. Okay, so these are two completely different, gigantism and acromegaly are completely different. Okay, no, it's mainly, it is seen visibly, it is seen as what, disfigurement of the face, but internal organs are also going to expand beyond a particular limit, so it becomes very difficult for orientation, and therefore it's going to cause the death. Only face elongation se kuch nahi hota. Okay, it may even lead to, you know, like tremendous obesity and all. Also look at this girl's face now, you can see that this almost neck is not seen only, right? And it is like pura swollen face lag raha hai uska. Okay, so internally also it's going to expand, it's not only external appearance. Is it fine? Have you all understood about acromegaly, gigantism and dwarfism? I hope no confusion in your minds. Anyone having any difficulty in this, come on, tell me. It is not going to affect only the face, it is going to affect all parts of the body, externally also and internally also. But the first symptom that would be seen as an acromegaly person is going to be via the face. Okay, face se pata chalta. Yeah, you know, like sometimes some people have got extension of the nasal bone और दी टो ऑफ योर फीट, देखा है आपने वो कभी कभी, है ना, एक एज के बाद, है ना, ड्यूरिंग द मिडिल एजेस ना, वो थोड़ा इलोंगेट हो जाता है. सो इवन दैट इज गोइंग टू बी, यू नो, अ माइनर केस ऑफ एक्रोमेगली, नॉट कंप्लीट, अ माइनर थिंग, बट देन यू नीड टू गो फॉर एन ऑपरेशन. एनी फैक्टर्स? नो, नथिंग. यस. सो देन, यू नो, लाइक दोज toes will become, you know, पीछे से थोड़े से elongate हो जाएंगे, crooked होते हैं, थोड़े टेढ़े हो जाते हैं, nose also gets disfigured, so then you need to operate on these. It's painful as well. If your toe bone increases ना, it becomes very painful for walking. बहुत गंदा pain होता है, तो उसको cut करना पड़ता है. लेकिन cut करने के बाद भी वो, है ना, वो वापस 10 साल के बाद grow होगा. Okay, any part of the body. Yes, but it could be on any part of the body. But first symptom seen is the face. Okay? Got it? Exactly. Now, what is the next one? See? Second hormone. What is the second hormone? Prolactin. Okay, so somatostatin was being made by the pars distalis. The second one is prolactin. Prolactin, PRL. No, you cannot prevent it. You cannot prevent it. There is no prevention. There is no cure. Okay. Prolactin or PRL, it regulates the growth of mammary glands and milk production. So it's going to be, you know, like during the puberty, the prolactin is the hormone which is going to help in the formation of the mammary glands. So it is going to regulate the growth of the mammary glands, as well as it is going to help in milk production. Bit of milk ejection alag or milk production alag. Humne already chapter of reproduction in humans mein dekha hai. We have seen these points. So PRL is going to have two functions. Regulation of the growth of the mammary glands and production of milk. Okay. These two are the ones which I told you are directly taken up as the function of the pituitary. They are not going to send any signals to any organs or any glands. But look at the third one. Third one is thyroid stimulating hormone, TSH. It stimulates the secretion of the thyroid hormone from whom? From the thyroid gland. So once the thyroid gland receives the signal via TSH, they will start functioning to produce their own products. So thyroid gland ke kaun se do products hai pata hai beta aapko? Do you know? You might have, I don't know if you have ever got tested for thyroid hormones. Thyroid test kabhi kiya hai kisi ka? Yes. Exactly. So you might have heard about the word thyroxin, T3, T4. We'll be doing all these in details, no doubt. Hum log karne wale. We don't do this. Aage aane hi wala hai ye sara content. So thyroid gland ko stimulate karne ka kaam kaun kar raha hai? TCH. TCH कौन बना रहा है? Pituitary gland. Pituitary gland का कौन सा एरिया? Pars distalis. Okay? So it is going to send the signal to thyroid gland. Fourth is ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone. It stimulates the synthesis and secretion of steroid hormones, that is glucosteroids or glucocorticosteroids, you know, from the adrenal cortex. So you do remember this corticoids that we had done in the chapter of digestion. Come on, bolo. Remember this. Corticoids. Come on. Humne kiya hai digestion wale chapter mein. Glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. Yaad hai? Learn these. Huh? These are going to be a part of your questionnaires of your FLT. So two types of corticoids bante hain, mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids. So here the adrenocorticotropic hormone is going to send the signal to the adrenal gland. Correct? Adrenal gland has got two parts, adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. So adrenal cortex ke yahan par ye ACTH aayega, bolega good morning, come on, wake up. Start making your glucocorticoid, signal आ गया है, फिर उनका मशीन चालू हो जाएगा. किसका मशीन चालू हो जाएगा? Adrenal cortex का. क्या synthesize करेगा वो? Glucocorticoid synthesize करेगा. Why it has started making the glucocorticoids? It got a signal in the form of what? In the form of ACTH. ACTH is produced by whom? ACTH is produced by pars distalis. Is it okay? Somatostatin, prolactin, thyroid stimulating, and adrenocorticotropic hormone. All four clear. What more is going to come in FLT? Everything will have equal weightage, beta. We have done. Okay. Got it? Any difficulty in this? ये तीनों में कोई डिफिकल्टी है? प्रोलैक्टिन, टीएसएच एंड एसीटीएच. एनीवन हैविंग एनी डिफिकल्टी विद दिस? कम ऑन, टेल मी. एक बार पढ़ लो, पढ़ के बताना बेटा. कुछ डिफिकल्टी है तो टेल मी प्लीज. डन? हाँ, डायग्राम वाइज. यस. So here you can see the mammary glands ka growth and regulation is going to be under the influence of prolactin. This is your thyroid gland, right? Thyroid gland ka functioning is also controlled by the pituitary hormone, which is going to be TSH. This is going to be your adrenal gland, which is a cap-like structure present on the kidney. It has got cortical area and medullary area or medulla. So cortex is the one who is going to synthesize the glucocorticoids. Okay, clear? Then we come to the fifth one, that is follicle stimulating hormone, FSH. Hai na? See, FSH stimulates gonadal activity. In males, FSH and androgens regulate sperm formation. So we have seen how spermatogenesis is taking place in detail in the chapter of human reproduction. Yes or no? In the same way, in females, FSH stimulates the growth and development of the ovarian follicles. So primordial follicle to primary, primary to Graafian follicle, everything, how it is going to, you know, go ahead. We have seen that how the FSH is going to be helpful in that particular activity. So here you can see that. Yeah, par dekho, this is the testes ka diagram. Huh? Here we can very well see the seminiferous tubules. Correct? So the follicle stimulating hormone, kiska good morning karayega? In case of males, testes ka good morning karayega. And in case of females, ovaries ka good morning karayega. So here you can see this, you know, all the follicles. So the primary follicle, yahan par, the primary primordial follicle, primary follicle, secondary follicle, Graafian follicle, secondary oocyte, corpus luteum, corpus albicans, all we have done. So all these transitional stages are only possible under the influence of FSH. Okay, so FSH is going to stimulate the gonads in general. In males, of course, the testes, in females, of course, the ovaries. Correct? Right? So out of the six hormones which the pituitary was making, two were made for direct use, while four were made for good morning of other glands. Correct na? Samajh mein aaya na? So the two which were directly used were which one? Somatostatin and prolactin. And char organs, yeah, char glands jinko good morning karana tha. Which were the four glands? Thyroid gland, adrenal cortex, then the testes and the ovaries. Idhar tak samajh mein aaya? Sixth one is still there, which I'm going to talk about, but idhar tak samajh mein aaya beta? Very simple and very easy. It seems to be easy because it's given in a very systematic format. Read your NCERT. Okay, now you will understand, of course. Well, the next one is going to be what? Luteinizing hormone. Right? You know the function of luteinizing hormone as well. Okay? They are also the ones who are going to stimulate the gonads. That is going to be your testes and the ovaries, of course. In males, it stimulates the synthesis of the secretion of androgens from the testes. Okay? And in females, it induces ovulation and maintains the corpus luteum. So these two functions are already known to you. Hai na? So all the six hormones that are going to be produced by pars distalis have been explained over here. So ye dekho beta, ye yaad hai tumhe? Sertoli cells, basement membrane, spermatogonia, first spermatocyte, second spermatocyte, spermatids, and then finally spermatozoa. Okay, same thing they have mentioned over here. So any difficulty in understanding the six hormones of pars distalis, that is adenohypophysis? Anyone? Somatostatin, prolactin, thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, the follicle stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone. All six we have discussed. Anyone who has not followed any point, ye wali jo names jab bhi maine jo bataye na beta, isko yaad rakhna. It's predominantly going to be asked in every exam of yours. Easy? Chalo. Ab isse bhi easy hai na the second one. That is going to be your pars intermedia. ये तो छह है, पार्स इंटरमीडिया सिर्फ एक ही हार्मोन सिक्रीट करता है. Shall we look at it? So, adenohypophysis का पार्स डिस्टालिस has the function of making six hormones, whereas पार्स इंटरमीडिया has got only one function. Only one hormone is going to synthesize. Which is that hormone? Let us see. pars intermedia in humans, it is almost merged with the pars distalis, almost merged. It produces melanocyte stimulating hormone, MSH. MSH acts on melanocytes to regulate skin pigmentation. So you know what is melanin? Heard about this word melanin? Pata hai? What is melanin, beta? What is melanin, pata? Yeah, what is the function of melanin basically? Impart color to the skin and everywhere, yeah, correct. Hair, skin, agreed, okay? That gives pigments, means it is responsible for color. Okay, so see, this is your pars intermedia over here. You can clearly see this pars intermedia, and it is going to synthesize melanin with the help of its cells called as melanocytes. Now, if you look very precisely, even your color is not uniform. Your color is not uniform. Okay, even you have got, you know, maybe your face is going to be having a lighter shade while your hands are going to have a darker shade. Okay, so more would be the melanin production, more would be the darkness of your skin. So even if you say that a person is fair or dark, it depends on what, beta? It depends on what exactly or how much exactly the melanin production is taking place. Okay, fine. So that is what is going to be the function of our pars intermedia. Okay na? Samajh mein aaya? Kisi ko doubt hai? What is your doubt? Melanin decides the color of the person. More the melanin, darker is the person. Yeah, more the melanin, darker is the person. But basically na, even in a person also, there is going to be variation. In every individual, look at yourself in the mirror. Or look at the color of your skin on your hand and a skin color of your face. Of course, it depends on the exposure to sunlight, because the melanin production will be increased because of sunlight. Why? Because melanin is going to be the one which is going to protect you from the harmful sun rays. ऐसे कहा जाता है कि जितना डार्क शेड रहेगा ना, उतना स्किन कैंसर होने के चांसेस नेग्लिजिबल होते जाएंगे. टैनिंग इज डिफरेंट, टैनिंग इज डिफरेंट. ओके, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी डिपेंडेंट ऑन द जीन्स. देयर आर सर्टेन जीन्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन आवर बॉडी व्हिच आर गोइंग टू कॉज द मेलानोसाइट्स टू सिंथेसाइज मैक्सिमम मेलानिन. Okay, and if you see the people who stay near the equator are dark shade. Okay, it can be changed. Yes. It depends on the environmental factors as well. So the people who are generally staying in the areas away from the, direct sun rays, in the away from the equatorial region, they are generally fair skin. And people who are around the, the ones who are going to get maximum sunlight, they are going to be generally dark shade. So why is it dark? It is not dark because of tanning activity. These people are dark because the melanin production has increased tremendously to prevent them from the harmful effects of these sun rays, because they are coming too much in direct contact with the sun rays. Fine. So they have, adapted to survive in such conditions where otherwise it will be very difficult for people like we to go and sustain over there for a lifelong. Correct? Got it? So who is the one who is going to produce this melanin? So MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, will be produced by pars intermedia, which will reach the melanocytes of our body. Where are these melanocytes? Head to toe, everywhere. And they will trigger the melanocytes to release melanin. ठीक है? Why these people have blood cancer less? Blood cancer का इतना ये नहीं है बेटा. It is predominantly with skin cancer. Okay? Skin cancers are very prominent. Yeah. Sun rays, UV radiations. sun rays are also going to, you know, give the UV radiations in the incident areas, which is going to cause mutations, which will lead to skin cancer. Okay, so to prevent that, you know, when the melanin is going to be present, it is going to act like a barrier. It will not allow the sun rays to percolate deep inside the skin and cause any harm to the DNA. Okay, so that is the main role of your MSH. Along with MSH, aur bhi aage aayega, which is going to give a peculiar skin color to us. Melanin ke hi production ke baare mein aage bhi hum kuch padhenge. But as of now, have you all understood only one hormone synthesized by the pars intermedia, that is MSH? Yes, beta. Yes. You are right. That is going to block the UV radiations from directly entering into the skin. Yes, correct. Okay. Well, so have you all understood this MSH and melanocytes wala point? So, ye khatam ho gaya pars intermedia. I told you na that pars distalis sabse zyada hormones banate hai, 6 hormones banate hai, whereas pars intermedia ek hi banata hai. In that case, melanin production, it would. Because it is an adaptation, as I say. Okay. So in that case, what will happen? In that case, it will increase its production. No doubt. Okay. Now, what is the other one? Come on, tell me. Third one, humne kya dekha? Humne pars distalis dekha tha, pars intermedia dekha tha. Now, we have to talk about what? Pars nervosa, that is neurohypophysis. Okay, they are already going to have ample amount of you know, the pigments, so it cannot get, you know, distinctly visible to us, though it gets. Skin is already light, so it will be immediately, you know, sensed by us. Theek hai. Neurohypophysis, as I said, pars distalis will synthesize, pars intermedia will synthesize, but this neurohypophysis, okay, will only store. So it stores oxytocin and vasopressin, which are the hormones synthesized by hypothalamus. Correct? So someone had asked me this question, that it is going to be the posterior pituitary which is going to synthesize these two. No, beta, it is the hypothalamus which is going to be producing these two, only stored over here. Is it okay? Let us look at the role of both of them. First is oxytocin. Oxytocin contracts the smooth muscles. Fine. We already know parturition that we had studied in human reproduction chapter. So in that, you know that the smooth muscle needs to be contracted. In females, it stimulates the contraction of uterus at the time of childbirth and milk ejection from the mammary glands. So I think someone was asking me about the function of oxytocin. I said, I'm going to talk about it. So these two important points, contraction of the smooth muscles and contraction of the uterus at the time of birth in females, and milk ejection from the mammary gland. So as I had said, na beta, that milk production, synthesis of milk, prolactin. Ejection of milk, oxytocin. Ye points humne reproduction in humans ke time pe bhi humne ye kiya tha. Again, I'm, you know, one more time telling you all, these are important points. Okay, got it? So this is the function of oxytocin. Any difficulty in understanding oxytocin? Okay. Was you? Fine. Anyone having any difficulty, beta? Understood very nicely. This is what we have done, so I think it will become easy. Okay. Then let us talk about the vasopressin. Okay. So just now we saw that there are two hormones, oxytocin and vasopressin. So we have already seen oxytocin. Let us see vasopressin. Okay, this is also which we have done just now in the chapter of excretion and osmoregulation, that is kidney ka function, but still I talk about it. Vasopressin, also called as anti-diuretic hormone or ADH, It stimulates reabsorption of water and electrolytes by DCD of the kidney. Correct na? Remember? Distal convoluted tubule of the kidney, and thereby reduces diuresis. What is diuresis? Loss of water through urine. So this is going to be helping in what? Concentrating the urine, ADH. Correct? हमने ये already देखा था excretion वाले chapter में, फिर भी मैं एक बार वापस से revise कर रही हूँ. Deficiency of ADH results in diminished ability of the kidney to conserve water, leading to excessive water loss and dehydration, which is called as diabetes insipidus. तो हमने already देखा था diabetes mellitus क्या होता है and diabetes insipidus क्या होता है. So in diabetes insipidus, there is lot of water loss from the body in the form of urine. Every after 10 minutes, the person will have an urge to urinate. So why is it happening? Because there is deficiency of ADH. So there is no reabsorption of water taking place. And that is the reason highly diluted urine is being continuously expelled out of the body. So that particular vasopressin, though it is coming under neurohypophysis, we know it is produced by hypothalamus. Neurohypophysis is the area for storage. Only when required, ADH or vasopressin will be released. Right? Understood? Any problem with understanding these two hormones, oxytocin and vasopressin, beta? Chalo bolo. Any difficulty for any one of you all? Nothing? Then we come to electrolytes. Where electrolytes? Huh? To maintaining the osmolarity? They have to maintain the osmolarity, right? So they have to have water as well as electrolytes for reabsorption. So we have seen H plus and K plus moving in, Na plus, glucose, all those things moving out, right? Yes. Well, the same way as we have seen the pituitary gland, now we come to the third gland. So see, we have seen hypothalamus, then we saw pituitary. Now we are talking about the third gland, that is pineal gland. So pituitary gland ka function khatam ho gaya. Okay? All the functions of pituitary gland we have understood. Adenohypophysis, six hormones, somatostatin, prolactin, TSH, FSH, luteinizing hormone, or ek kaun sa bacha? Batao, batao, batao. Which is the one? Suna ki nahi suna maine kaun kaun se bol? ACTH, ACTH, correct. Okay, fine. Then we talked about one hormone, which was MSH, intermedia produced kar raha tha. And neurohypophysis was storing two hormones, vasopressin and oxytocin. That's it. Ye fit hua kya? Fit hua dimag mein ye? Ye aapke dimag mein fit hona chahiye. Otherwise, when you read the content from your books, na it will mess up. Fix hua hai? Perfectly fit hua? It, or, you know, like you have to practice this, huh? Okay. Pineal gland. It is the smallest endocrine gland. Please remember, pineal is the smallest. Okay? Located on the dorsal side of the forebrain. So your brain is divided into three parts. Forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. So ye jo hai na, forebrain ke peeche ke side pe. Back side of the forebrain. It secretes melatonin. Ye melatonin bahut important hai apne liye. Though it is produced by one of the smallest endocrine glands, melatonin is very important. See why is it important? Look at its function. What are the functions of melatonin? It regulates diurnal rhythm of our body. 24-hour clock jo apna hota hai na? Sleep-wake cycle, body temperature, maintenance of our balance, everything is controlled by melatonin. तो आई डोंट नो इफ यू हैव एक्सपीरियंस दिस और नॉट, बट जनरली क्या होता है ना, रात में देखिएगा you start observing if you have not observed this. Every night, at a particular time, you will feel very sleepy. इतनी नींद आती है वो एक 10 मिनट का टाइम होता है. During those 10 minutes now you are actually lost. Once you cross those 10 minutes, once you overcome those 10 minutes, then you will not feel sleepy. Have you experienced this? एक टाइम आता है अपने पूरे मतलब दिन में, there is one, don't tell me पूरा टाइम हमें नींद आती है. I know you people, you know, you will tell me, miss हमें पूरा रात दिन नींद ही आती है. हाँ, yeah, exactly, yes, Anj. But you know, especially during night, there are so many people, you know, in front of me who would be studying at night. Anyone night watchmen over here? हाँ, yeah, yeah. Even I was a night watchman. Don't worry. मैं भी नाइट वॉचमैन का काम ही करती थी. मेरा जितना मेरा कंसंट्रेशन रात में लगता था ना पढ़ाई में, सुबह जल्दी उठ के कभी नहीं होता था मेरे से. आई वॉज वेरी बैड एट इट एंड माई पेरेंट्स यूज्ड टू ऑलवेज टेल मी कि बेटा जल्दी उठ के पढ़ाई कर, व्हाई आर यू यू नो एक्सटेंडिंग द नाइट सो मच. बट आई कुडंट, आई मीन माई एंटायर करियर I couldn't, you know, wake up early in the morning for studies. Raat mein kitna bhi bol. My dears, during our time, we did not have NEET. There was no competitive exam. Our admissions were completely based on the 12th standard marks. Okay, so, and we had PC, MBK marks collectively. Even maths was considered compulsory. It was mandatory. Okay, so you couldn't escape that. 96%. We were lucky. Yeah, I always think you all are lucky. Because options kitne milte hai tum log ko. Hame to wo long, bade answers likhte jao and maths mein bhi koi blunder ho gaya to gaya chance. So I used to feel that options nahi chahiye, options wala sahi hai. फटाफट मार्क किया, बात खत्म. ये लंबा लिख के हाथ टूट जाते थे हमारे. एंड अल्टीमेट वाज इवन मैथ्स वाज इंक्लूडेड, यू नो द एडमिशंस नेवर टूक प्लेस बेस्ड ऑन पीसीबी, इट वाज पीसीएमबी दैट टाइम, वेरी लॉन्ग बैक ऑफ कोर्स, उसको जमाना हो गया है. इट्स ओके, आई डोंट माइंड डूइंग दैट. इन फैक्ट अगर मुझे पूछा तो आई वुड हैव ऑलवेज प्रेफर्ड टू गो विद दिस एमसीक्यू टाइप ऑफ पेपर. जिसको जो मिलता है ना वो कभी उसमें खुश नहीं होता है, वो वाला कंटेंडेशन है अपने सबका, ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. व्हेन यू आर स्मॉल यू वेट कि मैं बड़ा कब हो जाऊं, जब तुम बड़े हो जाते हो फिर बोलते हो कि यार ये जॉब कब मिलेगा मुझे, मैं कमाने कब लगूंगा. व्हेन यू स्टार्ट अर्निंग यू विल फील ओ माय गॉड सो मच ऑफ टायरिंग, व्हेन विल आई गेट रिटायर्ड. हाँ, human tendency. yes, Bhumian, correct. So this is a trend, and when once we'll get retired you will feel so you know like a bored ki yaar mera kaam hi acha tha. Yeah, so yeah, exactly. So right now you enjoy your phase. What is your enjoyment? Koi tension nahi hai, bas padhai karni hai. Ha, बाकी का सब कुछ पेरेंट्स है देखने के लिए. सो नो वरीज अबाउट हाउ टू मेंटेन योर हाउस. एग्जैक्टली, दिस इज द ओनली टाइम व्हेन यू वुड एक्चुअली एंजॉय स्टडिंग एंड स्टडिंग. कीप ऑन स्टडिंग, इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ हार्डली यू नो कितना है अभी. नेक्स्ट ईयर तो यू ऑल विल बी गिविंग योर एग्जामिनेशंस, बोलने के लिए नेक्स्ट ईयर है. इट्स ओनली 15 मंथ्स. 15 fours are 60 weeks. Huh? 60 weeks sirf padhna hai tum logo. 60 weeks divided by 4 subjects. Kitna ho gaya beta answer? 60 weeks divided by 4 subjects. Physics, chemistry, botany, zoology. 15 weeks mein tumhe ye 4 subjects udane hain. To 60 weeks hi to hai. 15 months है. आज से अगर तुम काउंट करोगे तो 15 months. 15 fours are 60. So within 60 weeks you have to do all these things. So only have to study for 60 weeks. ऑल 38 चैप्टर्स क्या कर रहे हो? मैं फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री बॉटनी जूलॉजी की बात कर रही हूँ बेटा, मैं तो चार सब्जेक्ट्स की बात कर रही हूँ. हाँ ऑफकोर्स आई एम देयर, डोंट वरी, आई एम देयर टू हेल्प यू, गाइड यू एंड डू द थिंग्स एट द राइट टाइम, डोंट वरी एट ऑल, बट यू नीड टू डू. सो राइट नाउ स्टडी, दैट इज वॉट इज माई एम. डराने का काम नहीं कर रही हूँ, फैक्चुअल बात बता रही हूँ. एनीवेज सो सी, if we have hormones to control sleep and wake cycles, then why do some people have insomnia? Because they do not have this function, executed properly. Maybe their pineal gland is not secreting right amount of melatonin. Only then this particular disorder is going to be seen. So when we have got, two things. When it is going smooth, you will never realize it. If it deviates from the normal life, you will immediately realize it. Correct. So maybe right amount of melatonin is not being synthesized. Okay. Yes. It is also hormonal. Yes, but yes, Vaishnavi, very correct. Okay. So see, it's going to regulate what? Your sleep wake cycle, body temperature, influences metabolism. Your metabolism is also going to get influenced because of this secretion from the pineal gland. Pigmentation, as I said just now, that though melanin is responsible for giving a peculiar color, even melatonin is responsible for the color, even it is going to impart certain pigmentation. It alters your menstrual cycle as well. So anything wrong about the pineal gland secretions, what all things are getting impaired, just see. It influences our defense capability. So your immune system is also going to go weak. So pineal gland ko achhi tarah se sambhal ke rakhna hai hame. Hai na? Pineal gland, smallest gland, ek hi hormone synthesize karta hai. Kaun sa? Melatonin. But look at its diversified controls. Menstrual cycle, metabolism, body wake cycle, temperature, immunity, everything is going to be controlled by this melatonin secretion. And do you know when it is going to be produced or when it is going to be healthy? Pineal gland sabse zyada healthy kab rehta hai, pata hai aapko? When it will get good 7 to 8 hours of sleep. So my night watchman's like me, never to stay awake for a very long time. You have to give rest to your pineal gland for it to function perfectly. In a week, yeah, every day minimum 7 to 8 hours of sleep is required, beta. Okay, at least 7 hours ka sleep liya karo. Not less than that, otherwise the pineal gland will impair all your things. See, there are so many students who come to me that, as a patient also, they come and they ask, why there is so much of skin infection? Why there are so many, acne seen on my face? Or some people will come with, impaired menstrual cycle. Or some will have regular immunity problems. They are more prone to infections very often. So the reason of all these is no good amount of sleep. Because when you sleep only that time, the pineal gland is going to be, functional. Hai na? Arre baba, 10 se 12 ghante nahi karo. Haan, itna bhi nahi sona. Its optimum time is 7. Okay? 7 to 8. Don't sleep for 12 to 15 hours. Okay? I know, looking at our, overall functioning, we may not get 7 to 8 hours of sleep at a stretch, I agree, but try to. Okay? So any difficulty with this pineal gland? Have you all understood about it? Precisely. So, I won't go ahead with the thyroid gland as of today. Thyroid gland cut things, we will see it in the next class. So I'll stop today with the pineal gland. Take rest, give rest. Okay. Good, Bitta, good. So I hope you all have understood very precisely. Yeah, not getting proper sleep will overall have a negative impact on all your body functions. Very true. Okay. Bye. See you all, Bitta. See you on Friday. We'll go ahead with the thyroid gland onwards on Friday. Fine. Do well in your FLT. Of course, I'm going to meet you all before that to clear your doubts. Okay. Bye.